Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's another Siemens product. It's from about 1961. And this one is called Cathode Ray Relay Tester 109 by Siemens. And here's the Siemens order codes and all that. Really weird with the Siemens codes. I never really figured out the idea behind that. This unit is very, very special and very, very funny. I also got a bag of relays. And those relays, I believe they are telephone relays of a very, very special type. Set of reset relays, and the timing in those relays, the set relay or set reset timing, is very, very important. So this unit can actually test the timing in those relays, and this way a service technician is able to replace relays that is not doing the correct timing. So I believe here we set the mains voltage. This is of course the on-off switch. And here we go with the testing. So where we can see the different timing. And then image displacement. Here is the dropping resistor, and I haven't yet really figured out exactly what resistor to use here, because there's actually a manual here. Let me put some light here. And the fun thing about this manual is, let me remove the wire. Look, there is a really nice wire holding system here, like, so you wind up the wire in here, and even the socket you put here, and then you can close the lid without having the cable in the way. So here's the manual, and it says something about the dropping resistor. So the working voltage of the relay and this series resistor is of course important. I got absolutely no idea what kind of resistor values to pick, so I will start with a high value resistor and then just lower and lower the value until I hear the relay work or I get some sort of a response on the display. So this is the deflection of the CRT. This is mains transformer, and then there is a frequency divider, and then a filter, and then it drives the coil forward and back. And of course the contacts of the relay will then drive the CRT, and the original phase shifter will drive the deflection, and then you get a screen that tells you the time of your contacts in your relay. So yeah, it's going to be fun to see if this really works. I think if there is no relay mounted, I will just get a line, right? That is just my assumption. Oh yeah, I forgot to say about this manual here. If you unscrew the manual, there is a German version on the other side. Isn't that just nice? So if you happen to have this unit and it's in German and you want it to be English, yeah, just flip the manual. That is so cool. Yeah, I think we should try and power this up as it is and see what kind of power consumption. So I've dimmed the light. I've connected my chassis to earth protection, because in this mains cable I didn't see a third pin for a chassis grounding, and I really don't want to electrocute myself. So let's turn on mains. Is now applied, and I don't see any current consumption, so 21 watts. That is a lot of, I hear a lot of hum. Oh, there's a line, exactly what I thought. So here's my displacement. Okay, so this is left right displacement, and there isn't any pole reversal. How's that? I think this unit is so far working. There's a nice sharp picture. Oh yeah, by the way, if you lift this, you can create an even better picture, because you'll avoid shadows, but I'm actually creating a shadow. Well, that's just because my light is really bad. If I turn off that side light. See? Ooh, nice. I'm sorry about the noise from the relay, but it actually works. There's a little bit low deflection here. Compared to what the screen looks like here on the manual. But there's definitely a display, and then it shows the positive or the negative. And you can actually see the noise from the relay shifting here. So what I've done here is I got my little variable resistor box, and here by adjusting the series resistance down by cranking up this knob, we're going to add some more current to the coil drive. And then let's look at the timing at the same time. So now I'm gonna dial, go faster with more drive, and that is slower. So that's quite interesting. And here's the other contact. I mean, that is really nice and sharp. And let's try and give this more current. Yes, it goes faster. Ha! So I really believe this unit works. Let's open it and have a look inside, right? Yeah, let's do that. But first, I have to unplug. And did I forget to tell about the set relay? The set reset relay. The way that it works is there's a positive or negative current in this coil, and then it pulls or pushes the contact. But how is it remembering the position or holding the contact? That is done by a magnet. That one is the magnet. See? If I put a little piece of metal here, see? So there's a magnet inside a set reset relay. So that is real funny. This is a super, super beautiful relay. Look at those screws. Super, super special. Brass and everything here is adjustable. You can probably also, yeah, open this using those screws, and then perform a service to this relay. Beautiful. I must say this unit is just amazingly beautifully made. And there was actually a black wire for chassis in the mains. In the mains cable. So that is the phase shift, image shift. So there is a delay system using one of those transformers for the sweep. Of course, it's just sweeping using sine wave. And then there's another transformer for amplification of deflection. Maybe I should put in the schematic from a Radiomuseum so you can see all the different transformers. So the big one down there is the power supply transformer. And that relay you see here is actually the frequency divider. So this is also driven by mains. And of course, when it is a set reset relay, then the output is now half the frequency. And now that half frequency is driving the test relay. So it's the same relay that is inside. Let me rotate the unit. It is actually quite heavy. This is the voltage selector, mains voltage. So of course, this is the mains transformer we got up here, the big one. I don't know exactly where to put my fingers. I'm always a little bit careful with tube stuff. And especially CRT stuff, because this is running a little bit higher voltage. And I don't want to fry my little fingers. Mains transformer, deflection amplifier, right? And high voltage components. Oh, nice variable power resistor done like that. Beautiful. It's a very, very high build quality. I like the wires, and also look at the way that wires are taken out of this wire system here and then going up and down. So that means you can easily perform service. You can easily disconnect one wire and perform some experiments and then put it back again. Really nice. And the relay is mounted in this one. It's actually a little bit different. See, here is the spring effect. Normally those relays, they're mounted using a straight, non-flexible holder. Because I also got the contacts. So let's look at the last. Okay, yeah, we got the diodes, high voltage. It's probably that, it's probably the high voltage diodes. Yeah. That is of course needed for the CRT. Oh, that is a very, very nice tiny DG7 tube. It is really, really short. Look at my hands here. So that is the length of that CRT. So much electronics just to test the timing of telephone relays. Ah, I love it. High quality. And that is kind of all I wanted to show you guys in this video. I wanted to make it really nice and short. So please like and subscribe, and please come again. Bye bye.